you hold your hand out, she'll turn on back. Better walk, don't talk, she's all pretend. Can't be her friend unless you spin. Wall to wall, after all, get ready to throw. Only money at the bitch, cause he thinks she's so
sophisticated.
Chemical look. Wishes and desires getting worse with age. She don't want a man, all she wants is a page. Ain't got a man, so she goes to a club. She thinks it's classic, but it's really a pub. But that's the kind of place where she likes to go. The bitch got a problem, cause she thinks she's so
sophisticated.
So
sophisticated.
One of those guys, sucker too funny like it ain't no thing. Pretend to be friends and don't want that thing. Talk like this, don't talk slang. Do anything to get that thing. Tries to be chic and playing it off. Peek it through the window, so I'll take her clothes off. Nasty girl, a stone cold freak. Staying in the bed a whole goddamn week. Coming and leaving guys serving up storms. From execs with checks, boys from the dorms. Never kept a name, never seen her face. She can pass him in the street like it never took place. I know she's a hoe, so I'ma go. Expose the funky bitch, cause she thinks she's so
sophisticated.
So
sophisticated.
So
sophisticated.
So
sophisticated.
And if you ain't got it, she'll turn you away. You can smile with style as you profile, but you got it go to and she thinks you're wild. She don't want a brother that's true and black. If you're light, you're alright, better you stay back. Cause the sucker with the bag is out to catch, with something in his bag keeping her attached. The man got a plan, it's IBM. The devil at a level, yes, it is him. His alley, she rides his golden clothes. The ill-based method turning up her nose. Alack, cold beaming her up. She still got the nerve to turn her fucking nose up. Her status was status from down below. Now the bitch is in trouble, cause she was so
sophisticated.
So
sophisticated.
So
sophisticated.
So
sophisticated.
About her past, so listen to me, cause I know her ass. Used to steal money out of boyfriend's clothes. Never got caught, so the story goes. She kept doing that to all her men. Found the wrong man when she did it again. And still to this day, people wonder why. Did he beat the bitch down till she almost died?
Sophisticated.
105.7
So, what would you describe Fear of a Black Planet as? I mean, an album, does it cover a great genre of subject matters? Or?
Subject matters and perspective and music coming from, I guess, from the black vibe in the United States in different areas and also internationally. You know, our belief is that, you know, there should be no man or woman on this planet without, you know, and the planet should be shared equally, and I think that's what God wanted and God planned, so... You know, racism exists in every single, I guess, culture, every single country here, you know, in the Western world. And, you know, we're trying to abolish it by just saying, you know, everybody should treat each other with some kind of respect. And we, you know, put the album together looking through the eyes of of a black man or black woman or whatever, you know, United States. What we see going around us, that's kind of foul. And we, you know, put two and two together and put on a piece of wax called Fear of a Black Planet. And, you know, it was a step from, it takes a nation of millions to hold us back, and also a step from Yo Bum Rush the Show. You know, we try to do each and every album different from one another.
Have you started plans for the next album?
Yeah, putting that on paper. But what we're going through in 1991 is a full production scale of a whole bunch of new groups and new ideas and, you know, new concepts, you know. So Public Enemy has kind of been pushed up to November, December, or maybe into 1992. Terminator X and the Valley of the Jeep Beats is being developed now, with a whole lot of vocalists working with Terminator X, as far as a compilation type of thing. And then Flavor Flav has his own solo album coming out in the beginning of the summer of 1991. So you see, we're branching just in different ways, just on the PE concept, or reaching more people on that tip. There's a sister named Sister Soldier, who me and Hank Shockley are producing, you know, who's coming off on a whole nother vibe. And then there's a whole bunch of other groups that take on the flavor of Rappin' B, which was developed with the Bell Bivens and DeVoe Project, you know. So a lot of things looking up for us in 1991, and we only ask God, you know, to, you know, keep blessing us with the help that he's given us, and I think we'll do all right.
At the count of three, I want you all to tell me the name of my DJ. 1, 2, 3.
Yo, I gotta hear that one more time, man. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, boy, for all those that didn't understand Terminator X.
Missionary Lord, son of a gun, going on and on. That crack in the whack, explaining that, y'all, for the actual fact.
Come on.
Go!
clock and the enemy should be clocking the time. Checking records, I'm making your fourth effect of my rhyme. No provoking, no joking, you know the stage is set. If you're thinking I'm breaking,
he ain't rocking shit.
My education is taking you for a long ride. I make your brain slip and do the ride into infinity, it's infinite. With your hand in your pockets, I know your money is spent. Like this, like that, brother for the fat.
You kill my dog, I'ma slay your cat.
Just like that, y'all. Can you handle it, son? I'm public enemy number one.
Now, Flavor, you have a bit of a cameo role in Mo Better Blues, the Spike Lee movie.
Oh, you seen that, huh?
Yeah, I've seen it. It's a great film.
Yo, thanks a lot, man. You know, thing I like to do, you know what I'm saying, is use my voice sometimes more than my face, you know, because, see, you know, when I use my face, it's going to be for a movie that, you know, I want to create, you know what I'm saying? And this movie that I want to create is called Lifestyles of the Rich and Flav. You're going to love this. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, though, you know, I appeared in other movies like New Jack City and, you know, some other movies and stuff. You know what I'm saying? You know, so I can't really get into all of this right now. You know what I'm saying? But anyway.
But you have...
Harry, what you looking at, psych? But anyway.
He's using his voice for, I think, Tougher Than Leather. And
yeah, I use my voice for Tougher Than Leather, Mo Better Blues.
We made a short appearance in the brand new Spike Lee movie.
What's the name
Jungle
of it?
Jungle Fever.
Yeah. And, yo, Jungle Fever is about a black man who falls in love with a white woman from Howard Beach, right?
Right, and they're going through a whole bunch of, you know, people looking at them from both sides, on the whole racism tip. And I think Spike Lee tries to do what we try to do in our music, is try to talk about this various aspects of racism from even both sides and try to clear things up or talk about the untalked about, you know, in order to make it, make it as far as a point of dialogue to clear the air in the future. You know, for people to truly live together, they got to straighten out a lot of things that aren't touched upon.
Yeah.
It seems to me, as a person who doesn't live in America but reads the newspapers, that America is still a very racist country. I mean, the Ku Klux Klan has sort of re-emerged down south. What is gonna happen in America?
Well, we don't make predictions.
Yeah.
What is gonna happen is that the people that need their rights and rightfully need to deserve theirs is gonna come their way, one way or another. Or Armageddon's in full effect, like we say in one of our records. But to make a long story short, you know, it's just that, you know, like, the American system has done a lot of devious things, and there's a lot of dirt, and you can't sweep it under the rug. So a lot of those things are coming to show up today. And it's kind of, you know, show that there's this serious unbalance there.
And to make a real live long story short, whatever's going to happen is going to happen. Whatever happens was meant to happen, because if it didn't happen, it wasn't meant to be. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, like Chuck said, we can't make predictions, man. Only one that can predict life is God, the maker, the owner, creator of this planet Earth, and the God of this universe. You know what I'm saying? That created us all. So he's the one that make the predictions, you know?
Well, see, I come to Australia, and I see that, you know, there's a lot of people even admitting that, you know, what was done to the Aborigines here was kind of messed up, you know. But at least a lot of people are knowledgeable about it and do admit it. In the States, you know, we went through slavery 310 some odd years, and you still see a lot of people that don't know about that, or they refuse to acknowledge that fact, or the reason why we as black people in the United States are kind of disoriented, you know what I'm saying? We can't build a base, but we worked for the land for so many years, and we were taken from one place and brought over to another place in captivity. So, you know, a lot of people in the United States are not informed about this, or they choose to, you know, ignore the fact that this, you know, is the reason why we kind of messed up today and trying to get back up the staircase, you know. So at least, you know, that's the difference in the two countries that I see right off the bat. You know, at least there is acknowledgement to some degree that, you know, that the settlers here, you know, back in the days did F up, you know, and just wrongfully took and bogarted the land. But, you know, you don't have that vibe in the United States. So as long as you ignore that fact, you know, you got a problem.
A whole lot of musical influences, you know, and the reason why I say it like that is because, for once, you know, myself, I'm a musician, you know, and I play a lot of instruments, you know what I'm saying, and the world don't really know the side of me, you know. Maybe few people might now, being that they've been ready through interviews and everything, but myself, I don't have a favorite type of music. All types of music is my favorite, you know what I'm saying. I don't really have a favorite musical artist. Mostly all artists in the field of music is my favorite artists, you know what I'm saying? So that means that, you know, I don't favor nothing. I favor everything, you know what I'm saying? As long as it's in the path of perfection, which is the direction, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I grew up listening to all types of music, you know what I'm saying? From, I mean, when I was a little kid, you know, my father had me listening to, like, jazz, you know what I'm saying? Jimmy Smith, King of the Organ. Shirley Scott, Queen of the Organ, you know what I'm saying? Stanley Turrentine, Dizzy Gillespie, you know what I'm saying? I was listening to a lot of Louis Armstrong and Nat King Cole's and stuff. But then I had my Temptations and Supremes, James Brown, you know what I'm saying? And Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, going all the way up to, like, to rock, you know what I'm saying? Led Zeppelin, Seals and Crofts, you know what I'm saying? I used to listen to a whole bunch of stuff that a lot of people wouldn't listen to, you know what I'm saying? I listened to a lot of classical music too, you know what I'm saying? Some of my favorite artists was like Billy Cobham. He's a drummer, you know what I'm saying? And the boy is bad, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, one of my favorite bass players of the world was a bass player for Earth, Wind & Fire by the name of Verdeen White. You know what I'm saying? And Stanley Clark, you know what I'm saying? I mean, yo, man, I could just go on and on and on, you know what I'm saying? So I don't have a favorite. All the people in the music business, you know what I'm saying, that's even deceased now, was inspirational to me, you know what I'm saying, which led me up to where I am right now in Australia, talking to you, man.
kin. That's all right, I try to do what a brother does, but I'll never know if you're my cuz. That's why I try my best to unite, then the rest of it'll like it. Banned from in the arena, his word from the motherland, has anybody seen her? Jack was nimble, Jack was quick. Got a question for Jack, ask him. 40 acres and a mule, Jack. Where is it, why you try to fool the black? It wasn't you, but you pledged allegiance to the red, white, and blue suckers that stole the soul.
Public Enemy have a very heavy rap sound, whereas say De La Soul and Tribe Called Quest are a little lighter and more sort of light-hearted. Are you still brothers with them? I mean, do you think they put the message across as well as you do, but just in a different way?
I think all rappers got a good way to get their message across. They have their own certain way. You know, Public Enemy is just one of a troupe, of a cast of hundreds, you know, rap groups that are trying or that are putting their message out. You know, I call ourselves Disciples of Run DMC. I decided to put a group together that would be hardcore and also, you know, to be followed by a lot of the brothers, you know, to be that type of group, you know, coming from a heavy, hardcore, male-oriented, you know, rap edge, you know. My influences as far as, you know, Run DMC or LL Cool J or Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, as well as, you know, your Sly Stones and your Temps and your Four Tops. So, you know, I kind of put those days and these days together to come up to what, you know, what we put together with our dense sound, you know. So I like the loose sound as well, you know. But, you know, as everybody else tries to follow your sound, then you switch off and you go to some other sound. Maybe one day we'll get real loose. Maybe one day we'll get real dense, you know. I think rap music, or Public Enemy in particular, is something that you can't really put your finger on. A lot of people would like to say it's noise, but it's a lot more than just noise.
Yo, you know what I want to say far as to that? You know, a lot of people that don't even really listen to rap music, and they really hate it so much. The reason why I feel that they hate it is because I really feel like they don't know how to listen to it. So, you know, they don't really understand it. You know, like Chuck D say, you know, it's a lot of people that think it's like noise. Yes, yes, y'all, to the beat, y'all, rock on, y'all, you don't stop. But you got to stop and really listen to the lyrics, you know what I'm saying? Because there's a lot of messages in rap music that one day might really help you out, man, or save you and your family's life one day, you know what I'm saying? And a whole lot of information is going by because people misunderstand it or people misconcept it. You know what I'm saying? The whole nine. So, you know, just trying to let everybody know that a rap music is just another form of music that joined the business of music. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people say that rap music was going to die a long time ago. But as they say that it's going to die, it becomes 10 times as much stronger as they say it's going to die. You know what I'm saying? And not only that, but right now, we got little kids, man, from 3, 4, and 5 loving rap music, and one day they want to grow up to be like us older rappers, you know what I'm saying, us older, you know, music makers, and that's going to be more and more years of rap music making. Think about that, you know what I'm saying? So rap will never die. Maybe one day, you know, a lot of people will stop misunderstanding rap music and learn how to listen to it, and then it's going to become even bigger.
Yo, Chuck, you tell the dribbles are still front on us. Tell them we can do this, because we always do this.
How low can you go? Death row? What a brother, no. Once again, back is the incredible rhyme animal, the uncannibal thief. Public Enemy number one. 5-4 said freeze, and I got numb. Can I tell them? Never really, never had a gun. But it's the wax that determined the X-Bun. Now they got me in a cell, cause my records they sell. Cause a brother like me said, well, Farrakhan's a prophet, and I think you wanna listen to what he can say to you. What you wanna do is follow for now. Power the people say, make the miracle. Keep up the lyrical. Black is back, all in, we're gonna win. Check it out. Here we go again. Bring the noise.
Hey, yo, Chuck, they saying we too flat, man.
Bring the noise.
Yo, I don't understand what they're saying, but little do they know they can get a smack for that, man.
Never batter than bad, cause a brother is madder than mad at the fact is corrupt like a senator. Soul on the road, but you treat it like soap on the rope, cause the beats and the lies are so dope.
for lessons I'm playing inside music that the critics are all blasting me for. They'll never care for the brothers and sisters why across the country has us up for the war. We got to get them straight. Come on now, they're gonna have to wait till we get it right. Radio stations are questioning their blackness. They call us a black, but we'll see you the greatest. Bring the noise. My DJ is warm, he's ex, I call him Norm, you know. He could cut a record from side to side. So what the ride, the glide, what should be safer than a suicide? Soul control, beat is the father of your rock and roll. Music for watching, for witching, you call a band man making the music of music, but you can't do it, you know. You call them demos,
but we ride the most too.
What you gonna do? Rap is not afraid of you. Beat is for Sonny Bono,
beat is for Yoko Ono.
Run the MC for a set of DJ, couldn't be a band standing its own feet, get you out your seat. Beat is for Eric B and LL as well, hell.
Watch is for Anthrax,
Silicon Rock Bells, ever forever, universal it will sell. Time for me to exit. Terminator exit. Bring the noise.
Yo, they should know by now that they can't stop me from
bring the noise.
Word up, gonna keep telling me to turn it down, but yo, word up, life ain't going out like that.
Come on. So you stop being like a comatose. Damn, my man, the beats are same where the bolt goes. Rock with some pizzazz, it will ask why you ask. Roll with the rock stars,
they'll never get accepted at.
We got the plead the fifth, you can investigate. No need to wait, get the record straight. Hey, Posse in the back, got flavor. Terminator, exercise, check, play to get paid. You got to check it out down on the avenue. A magazine or two is dissing me and dissing you. Yeah, I'm telling you.
Hey, yo, Griff, get the S1W.
Well, you're certainly role models, aren't you, for the younger generation?
We try to, not only that, but we try to be role models to, you know, to influence younger people into the right direction. Because that's our direction, you know what I'm saying? Public Enemy's direction is perfection. If we see any type of mistakes, we try to make the correction. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we try to influence people to do the right thing, to be good in school, you know what I'm saying? Do the right things in school, get those degrees and everything that the teachers got to teach you, you know what I'm saying? It's all about a unity thing. You know what I'm saying? I don't care what nobody say, you know. I know, Chuck, man. You're writing something.
It's like
trying to tell me, shut up, Flav. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, brother,
he's drawing me right now.
Brother D and the collective effort said, how you going to make a black nation rise? You got to agitate, organize.
Well, you organize and you let everybody know the information that they need to know, and then, you know, that's what you call about organization and agitation. Sometimes the information could be a turnoff to some people, but if everybody knows, you know, then you could start off from a beginning base.
I got a brand new funk.
Kick down,
party for your rock.
Let's get it on, like we said before. Single brothers for the trouble, hit the busted bubble, cause we rumble from our lower level.
To condition your condition, we're gonna do a song that you never heard before. Make it all come along to the education. Brothers gotta work it out and stop chasing. In the street all willing to work it out.
Come on, y'all, let's go to work.
So many of us in limbo, how to get it on? It's quite simple, three stones from the sun. We need a piece of this rock.
Go!
Indestructible soul. Answers to this wisdom to the brothers in the street.
School!
And a business. History shouldn't be a mystery. Our story's real history, not
this.
We gonna work it out one day till we all
get paid
the right way in full. No
styles. Yeah. One day, the brothers gonna work it out. United we stand, yes, divided we fall together. We can stand tall, brothers that try to work it out. They get mad, we both revise, realize they're super bad. Small tech and smart brothers gonna be a victim of his own circumstance. Sabotage, shell shock, rock, and boom. They in the life of a fool, like I said before, the living low. Life, take your time, time, yo, go, slow. Look ahead, not a thing to fear. Brother to brother, got another as sincere. Teach a man how to be a father, to never tell a woman he can't bother. You can't say you don't know what I'm talking about. But one day,
I'll just slip over.
Brother's gonna whip it out. In the street are willing to work it out.
It's got to start somewhere, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, hey, it's all about a unity thing, you know? Hey, yo, you know what? Not only that, but take commercials right now, right? TV commercials. Do you know that a lot of TV commercials are starting to use rap tactics now?
Sure.
To sell their products?
There's one for Kentucky Fried Chicken on the television here that sort of cuts up an old MC Hammer song.
Yeah, way back in the days, Colonel Sanders said rap was going to die. Now look at him. Yeah, you want to hear old Kentucky Fried Chicken joke?
Yeah, sure, Flavor.
Yo, what was Colonel Sanders doing running around in the chicken coop butt naked? He was dicking chicken.
Well, listen, guys.
Oh, shoot. That's a Flavor joke, man. I eat Kentucky Fried Chicken, too. I just hope he didn't touch my chicken.
Flavor and Chuck D, unfortunately, you've got to zoom off now. Thank you for coming into Triple J.
Do the shows tonight. Yeah, do the shows tonight and tomorrow night and guaranteed to wreck the place.
Yeah.
You know, we like to exert a lot of energy on our shows and get the crowd going, you know. When we first came along, we saw that, you know, that a lot of rap groups used to do shows that were about 20 minutes.
Sure.
Half an hour.
How long's the Public Enemy show?
Sometimes we could go to 2 hours and 2:15.
Yo, man, let me tell you something. We can go to infinity. I ain't gonna lie.
We could go as long as the crowd can stand the heat.
Yeah. But the reason why I say we can go into infinity is because we can't go into infinity because there's always a curfew. Come on, man. Let's stop curfews and let's just rock the house, man. You know what I'm saying?
All right, so you're playing tonight and tomorrow at the Horton Pavilion in Sydney and Saturday night at the Festival Hall in Melbourne.
Right.
And,
yeah.
Look out.
Yeah. Look out. And not only that, but look out, Triple J, because we're going to stay on your way.
That's right.
And every time we make something dope, it's something you'll play.
And all the people that just think that Public Enemy is wrong or we racist, whatever, like we say before, you know, don't believe the hype.
Word. And for all you people in the media that say we are racist, you need a smack in your faces. That's right, we real good, you need to taste this. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, yo, as we continue on our way, the only thing I can say is in the place to be, Triple J 5000G. You know what I'm saying? 5000 means Audi. You ever heard of the Audi 5000? That car? Well, you know, everybody used to say, okay, bye, I'm Audi. Come on, that's corny, man. You say, yo, man, I'm 5000G. You know what I'm saying? And you want to know what G means? G is for the guys. G is for the gals. G is for good. G is for grand. G is for also what my man Tony the Tiger that make Frosted Flakes say. Great. You know what I'm saying, G? Yeah, G. So 5000G. Yo, this is Public Enemy signing off for Triple J. I keep running my mouth, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't never stop, you know what I'm saying? Murder upon the strength, you know what I'm saying? We was wheeling, with the boom in the back, kicked that shit, Chuck, because it was like that, you know what I'm saying?
You're on the radio, man. You keep cussing like...
Yo, he said it's all right. That's why I did it. Come on, man. Oh, believe me. If it wasn't all right, I wouldn't say a curse because I just have to let everybody know that I do know how to speak properly, you know, and I do have a little bit of intellect. But fuck that shit, man. Word up to you on the strip. You know what I'm saying? Hey, yo, man.
All right, we're going to kick one verse of Don't Believe the Hype and check it out, all right?
All right, back. Kick
back.
It, G.
Of course, you're looking for the same thing. It's a new thing. Check out this spring. Uh-oh, the robo low the level because I'm living low next to the bass.
Come on.
Turn up the radio.
Yeah.
They're claiming I'm a criminal.
Yeah.
But now I wonder how. Some people never know. The enemy could be their friend, guardian. I'm not a hooligan. I'm about to party and clear all the madness. We're not racist. Preach the teach to all.
I never had this.
Number one. That boy run about the gun. I wasn't licensed to have one. The minute they see me, fear me. I'm the epitome of public enemy. Use, abuse without clues. Will refuse to blow fuse. They even had it on the news.
Don't believe the hype.
Don't believe the hype.
Don't believe the hype.
Don't believe the hype.
Don't. Pop.
Don't believe the hype. Yo, Harry Allen, you gotta ask him.
Yo, Harry, you're a writer. Are we that tight?
Don't believe the hype.
Yeah, boy.
And we out of here, 5000.
Test two, baby.
Trying to tell you now.
And if you think that we can't do something for you, then we can't do nothing for you, man.
I can't do nothing for you, man. Man, I can't do nothing for you, man. I can't do it for you. Oh, running for your life, running from your wife. Yeah, you should have stuck at home. On your mind to blow your dome. It was you that chose you to. You built some things you can't get through. I tried to help you all I can. I can't do nothing for you, man. I can't do nothing for you, man. You got all these people on your back now. I can't do nothing for you, man. I can't do nothing for you, man. Don't leave on shelves.
Answer, man.
I can't do nothing for you, man. You chopped out of the jelly into a jam. Make the left or wrong instead of right. Gonna be got burglar through the night. Got caught the girl, her name was Cheryl. About a roof that blacked the steel of pro. Fools, he down, no bullets in the gun. The judge might throw away them stuff and stuff. The lawyer tried to help them all again, but they couldn't do nothing for you, man.
Yo, Jay, let's
do it.
from the gun. I'm a friend that wears a gun. Can't face my back, that gun is so good. You want my hand out for you, well. Keep well fit, turkey out again. I can't do nothing for you, man. I can't do nothing for you, man. You want $6? I can't do nothing for you, man.
Rock that shit, homie.
I ain't tryna hear that.
Get that shit.
You on welfare. Get that shit.
Motherfucker.